It's no surprise that obesity is a problem in America, and Hawaii is no exception. Now, some facing the problem may consider surgery. Today, we meet a man who underwent bariatric surgery and says the procedure changed his life.
For the last 12 years, I've been a commercial airline pilot, and maintaining my health is one of my requirements as a pilot. And my weight was starting to get out of hand. My weight had always been an issue for most of my life. And I kind of reached a maximum weight that I just wasn't comfortable with, but I wasn't quite sure what to do. At the beginning of 2014, I started researching my options and found the Castle program with Dr. Steven Fowler and decided after its informational session to use his program to perform my surgery. When I first started researching the different programs, I was afraid I was going to be a number and not a face. That was completely dispelled when I met Dr. Fowler and his staff and also the staff at Castle Medical Center. I soon realized that I was a name with a face and they cared about my individual success, not just the numbers they needed to push through the program. Since my surgery, things have been going really well. I followed the guidelines that the practices recommended. And it's taken hard work and dedication, but the results have been phenomenal. I'm definitely a lot more active than when I used to be. And even in my normal job as a pilot, I can move around a lot easier, both when I have to walk around the plane and go up and down the stairs to the plane. Friends and family and coworkers have been amazed at the change. And it's nice to hear the reactions that I've seen after the weight loss. My weight before surgery was 305 pounds. Now my weight less than a year later is 172 pounds. So I've had a loss of 133 overall.
Wow, congratulations to him. Now he just looks happier. Now here with more information on bariatric surgery and obesity in general, Dr. Steven Fowler, bariatric surgeon at Castle Medical Center. Hello.
Hello.
Thanks for joining us.
Nice to meet you.
Before we get into bariatric surgery, can you just tell us, you know, what are some of the common causes of obesity?
Well, you could probably point a finger just about in any direction, you'd be correct. So it's certainly multifactorial. But there's no doubt that there's probably some overriding themes that are going on in our society today that are making people more unhealthy. The food we eat today is fundamentally different than, you know, what our grandparents were raised with. So the quality of food is very different, so higher processed sugars and fats, and there's been some evidence linking obesity related to that. We live in a high-stress environment. As you know, when the body's in stress, it holds on to energy. Energy is in the form of fat, and so you see people gaining weight in that respect, and then we're in a more sedentary lifestyle. So it's a variety of different things, but for such a rapid change in our society that we've seen this growth of obesity, it's probably important that people emphasize that it's the environment that we live in versus the individual as the cause.
Okay, and what is considered an unhealthy weight?
Good question. Medical societies, our society changes over time in terms of what we deem an appropriate weight. So I don't necessarily know that answer, but I do know that an appropriate weight is one that does not have bad health conditions associated with it. So, you know, diabetes, hypertension, obstructive sleep apnea. So one where there's an absence of those, that would be good. And so we need to be focusing on the medical conditions that go in with a weight, and that would be an appropriate focus.
And sometimes weight loss can improve, right, your health conditions.
Absolutely.
Diabetes.
However it's done, you're going to see an improvement in those.
All right. So what options are available to help us get to a healthier weight?
It can be the whole gamut. So, you know, from a easy intervention would be a lifestyle change to something as severe as considering a bariatric operation. And so there's kind of a continuum of interventions that someone can employ. And so it can go from just the very basic to the most significant, which is kind of where I get involved.
Okay, so let's talk about when you get involved. For someone who might be considering bariatric surgery, can you tell us what that process is like?
It's a big process. It's a lifestyle change. Once you go down that road, it's kind of a forever. It's going to be something different for you. And typically, patients who do go that route, it's a situation where they need to make that change from a health standpoint. So it's nice to lose the weight, but we're interested in obtaining an improvement in the patient's health. And to do a bariatric operation successfully, that involves a team approach. You know, I'm very important for one day of the patient's life while I'm on the operating table, but having that teamwork of dietitians and exercise specialists and psychologists and pre- and post-op nursing care, following people long-term, support group, That's part of a bariatric program.
That's a really good point, because a lot of people may want to lose weight and they're looking at the short-term change, but they're not realizing the amount of work it's going to take to maintain that.
Absolutely. Right? You know, surgery is not an easy road. It is a level of commitment on the highest level. Mm-hmm. And so it's a very commendable aspect to go that route. But again, it's really, to have it work well, you need to bring in all those other facets of improving the patient's health.
Now, you guys offer monthly informational seminars?
Sure. So that's through the Castle Medical Center. Mm-hmm. And they can go ahead and go on the website and just find out information through there. And yeah, it's a free information seminar. And basically, my job is to present, you know, what is bariatric surgery and if it's appropriate for them. And it might be appropriate or might not. It's not right for everybody.
Right.
So just to kind of give them some background information to see if it's right.
Okay, doctor. Thank you very
much.
Thank
you. It was
a pleasure.
Very
interesting. And we're going to have all that information on our website.
Great. Thank you.
As well.